Okay, good evening class. Everyone ready for the next session?
Yes.
Don't sound very convincing.
Yes.
Shall we quickly run through what is the difference between tour guides and cultural heritage specialist guide? Do you remember some of the words earlier on? No?
No.
What is bigger? Body bigger? Now, bigger in terms of for tour guiding, usually you go on a coach, numbers are bigger. There are more people, okay? That means there are a lot more distance between you and your tourists. And it's not so inclusive because you are on a coach. You're not including the community, for example, okay? And there's less concern because you have not much time, you have to finish your itinerary and you go fast. And less question. Sometimes you can also avoid the question asked by the tourist because you can just answer some other person's question. And what do you mean by touch and go, remember? Touch and go, very fast. Okay? Now for cultural specialist guides, it's different. Numbers are smaller. 2 person, 3 person, sometimes a family. Then we have the, because we are dealing with most of the time often working, we are closer with the tourists and closer with the local communities. Inclusive as well and more concerned because we start to know all these people and we are also worried and concerned about their problems and issues as well. More question of course, sorry about that. Okay, more question and a lot of times you cannot avoid those questions. So we have to be truthful and at the same time tactful. And in-depth knowledge means knowing your sites, the World Heritage sites, the management section, from listing to management and also current issues. Yeah? Okay? Now, ways to make the trail interesting and thought-provoking. A lot of times we work on themes. Okay, themes. So I'm going to show you a picture and what is your first question in your mind? What is your first question or first word in your mind?
So you can get me.
Look at the things. Look at the things here. Okay, makan. That's a good word. Food. Agree? Food. So you are doing a food trail. Now, often on the bus you pass and you don't even have time to point out. But when you're walking, you will see this. Now, next, as a cultural specialist guide, what are your questions up here? What are your questions?
What kind of food?
What kind of food? Okay, what else?
Why do you sit like that?
Yes, why do you sit like that? Okay? One last question. I hope somebody can give me that question.
When is the last break?
Now why? Why would they want to sit like that while they're eating? Agree? Okay? Now if you were to go back, ask them this few questions. Do you think you can find the storyline behind this?
Yes.
Why they came about like this? Okay? So by working on the question, you can come up with storyline and you can fit it into your food trail. Okay? So this is a theme on food, for example. Now food is a very popular tour now. Food is a very popular tour. Many of the tourists will pay a lot of money for your knowledge where to get the best food. Okay? I'm going to give you another picture now. Okay? Do you remember walking yesterday? Did anyone of you saw this?
Yes.
Now, first word in your mind. What is the first word?
Why such a unique decoration?
Green. Right. I was questioning this and I found out from a local that they are going to pray for. Last night, all of you were praying, remember? Okay? So this theme will have to do with something of praying or temples, you know, religious walk, for example. So find your theme and work out accordingly. Everyday things like this is very interesting to the tourists. Even for me as someone not from Melaka, coming in I realized that some of the things that they use for praying is so different from Penang. We don't see it in Penang, in Georgetown. Okay? Next. Can you see this guy here?
Yeah.
If your tourists want to know more about what he's doing, what is the first question you're going to ask him? Or what are you going to say to him? First question. What are you going to do? First question. Anybody want to try?
Ask him.
How long you've been doing this?
Would that be your first question?
Yeah.
Okay, anyone else?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, you got one more one.
Okay, almost the same. Okay, anyone else? I'm looking for this important question of statement or, you know, how old are you? How did you get him to open up? How are you? Apa kabar? You got to get him to open up before me, because some of them are too busy rushing to finish things, yeah? And once he has to reply, you know you can move on to the next question. And for photographs, for example, always ask their permission before you take photographs, okay? Okay, now, last but not least, time your theme, go to the side, make sure you know what's there, traffic, space, and all these things, and time it correctly that you have enough time for your guests to actually speak to the locals, yeah? Okay, thank you so much. We'll pass it on to...